Teams are an important part of nearly every workplace. In many firms, they are the key organizational unit, and team dynamics can affect overall productivity. Yet, there is limited economic evidence on how to organize teams effectively. One potentially important factor is past collaboration. A team's current performance may depend on whether its members have worked together before. In fact, if past experience leads individuals to learn specifically how to work well with one another, this may create skills and knowledge that cannot be transferred to collaboration with others. This paper explores the role of team-specific human capital in healthcare. This is a highly teamwork-intensive industry, and many medical studies have shown that poor teamwork between doctors is a key contributor to low quality of care. To test the impact of shared work experience on a team's performance, the author uses Medicare data and focuses on two procedures often used for treating heart attacks, PCI and CABG. These are two of the most common medical procedures among the US elderly population, and both typically require two types of doctors: the surgeon who performs the procedure, and the doctors who provide pre- and post-treatment care. Because these parties perform interdependent tasks, the quality of their collaboration may affect a patient's outcomes. For example, if issues that arise during treatment are not clearly communicated back to the physician, the patient's post-treatment quality of care may be lower. Crucially, proceduralist physician team switches are frequent. Doctors generally set their schedules independently and are subject to many constraints that make it difficult to coordinate shifts with another individual. This leads to substantial variation in the amount of shared work experience across different teams, and the author tests whether those with greater shared experience have better patient outcomes. An important feature in this setting is that even if patients wanted to choose doctors with more shared experience, the acute nature of a heart attack limits their ability to do so. To leverage this further, the paper restricts its initial analysis to patients admitted via the emergency department. Physicians' schedules are set well in advance, while patient admissions are typically unanticipated and require immediate treatment. Holding the proceduralist fixed, this generates quasi-random variation in the assignment of patients to doctor teams with varying levels of shared work experience. Accordingly, these figures show that predicted mortality rates, whether as a function of patient or physician characteristics, are nearly identical across ED doctor teams with different levels of shared work experience. This indicates that there are no systematic differences in the kinds of patients treated by teams with more shared work experience, or in the characteristics of physicians on those teams. And yet, when we look at actual mortality rates, there is a clear negative relationship. Patients treated by teams with more shared work experience have lower mortality rates. The results are similar when broadening the sample to all PCI and CABG patients, including those not admitted through the ED, and the magnitudes suggest that a 1 standard deviation increase in doctors' shared work experience reduces patient mortality rates by 10 to 14%. This implies that merely reorganizing doctor teams with an eye to their collaboration histories can significantly improve patient survival. What explains these effects? On one hand, repeated interactions may lead individuals to learn how to work and communicate better with one another, thereby enhancing their joint performance. On the other, doctors who have collaborated before and who have an existing relationship may exert more effort. For example, by performing more tests or extending a patient's stay. In this case, the improvement in patient outcomes may come at the cost of higher medical spending. To distinguish between these mechanisms, the author examines three commonly used measures of medical resource use and finds that all of them decline with shared work experience. Teams with greater shared experience achieve better outcomes, all while using fewer inputs. This suggests that past collaboration improves a team's productivity. Finally, an important question is whether general human capital can substitute for team-specific human capital. As a doctor becomes more experienced, does she become better able to work with any other doctor, regardless of their shared history? While the effect of shared work experience on patient outcomes does decline with proceduralists' and physicians' individual work experience, the decline is small. For PCI patients, a proceduralist's individual work experience needs to be roughly 4 standard deviations higher than that of the average proceduralist in order to eliminate the effect of shared work experience. As such, while individual work experience can substitute for team-specific human capital, the extent of that substitution is limited. Thus, this paper shows that doctors' past collaboration significantly lowers patient mortality. To put these findings in perspective, note that health insurance coverage is an often discussed policy tool for improving patient outcomes. But simulations suggest that the reduction in mortality that could be achieved by reorganizing providers to increase doctors' shared work experience is approximately 1/2 of the returns to Medicare coverage. Beyond the implications for healthcare policy, this illustrates the importance of team-specific human capital. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on the determinants of healthcare quality, as well as papers on teamwork and human capital accumulation.